Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is Angles Part 4. In this video, we learn more terms and definitions and learn some more symbols, and we work through two more problems. This is the first problem we do, and this is the second problem we do. So we're going to begin by coming up with a few more definitions and some symbols. First of all, parallel lines never meet. R and S below here are parallel. And we use this symbol, the two vertical little lines here, to mean is parallel to. So if I write R is parallel to S, that's what it looks like. Perpendicular lines are intersecting lines. They actually do intersect, but they intersect at right angles. So A and B are perpendicular, and we use this little symbol here, this sort of upside down T, to mean is perpendicular to. So this says A is perpendicular to B, and all these angles here are 90 degrees. So all four angles that you see here are 90 degree angles. In the previous video, we already discovered that vertical angles have the same measure and that adjacent angles of two intersecting lines form supplementary angles. So in this picture here of these two intersecting lines, A and C are vertical angles, so they have the same measure, A equals C. B and D are vertical angles, so they have the same measure, so B equals D. And also, each group here next to each other, the of a set of adjacent angles, are supplementary angles. So A plus B add up to 180 degrees, B plus C add up to 180, C plus D, and A plus D. They all, each pair of those angles adds up to 180 degrees. So if you have two intersecting lines, this is something we know about all the angles right off the bat. Okay, let's look at two parallel lines, S and R, and a transversal T. A transversal is a line that goes through two other lines. Okay? So we have two parallel lines and a transversal, I'll call that line T, going through it. You see that there are eight angles formed here. Now, when you look at all of these angles, there's something interesting. They're A, for instance, is a large angle where B is a smaller angle. See the difference? So you see four large angles, A, D, E, and H, and they actually all have the same measure. Now, corresponding angles are, if you look at this transversal here, you look on the same side of it and they're both on top, A and E, for instance, are called corresponding angles, or B and F are called corresponding angles, or D and H are called corresponding angles, etc. So hopefully when you look at this picture, it makes sense to you that the way this line cuts through parallel lines, that A and E should be the same measure. So I have that right here. A and E are corresponding angles, which have the same measure. We already talked about vertical angles before. There's a whole bunch of sets of vertical angles, A and D are vertical angles, or B and C. I've written a couple, just one pair, E and H right here, E and H. These are some vertical angles. Okay, there's a couple other terms here, alternate interior and alternate exterior angles. Here's what an alternate interior angle is. If you look in the interior between the two parallel lines, you look at angles that are on the opposite side of each other, but kind of alternate from each other. So C and F are on opposite sides of this transversal, but they alternate here, right? One's the on the left side and this one's on the right side, etc., below. So we say C and F are alternate interior angles, or I could say what else? D and E are the other pair of alternate interior angles. How about exterior? We're looking at what's above one of the parallel lines or and below the other parallel line. So again, on opposite sides, G and B are alternate, but they're exterior. and A and H are alternate but exterior. So all of these angles, alternate interior angles, have the same measure, alternate exterior angles have the same measure, corresponding angles have the same measure, and vertical angles have the same measure. But the main thing I want you to get here is that four of these angles are all the same. So watch. The big angles are all the same. A, D, E, and F are all the same. A, D, E, and F are all the larger of the two angles you basically see here. It is an obtuse angle, right? Those are all obtuse angles. And then we take all the smaller angles, and they're all equal to each other, B, C, F, and G. So B, C, oops, I think I said that wrong. This is what I did wrong. That was supposed to be E and H. There we go. Sorry. So B, C, F, and G are the smaller angles. Okay. So try to take that in. When you have two parallel lines and a transversal going through them, that there are really eight angles total, but there's only two measures that you're going to see, the obtuse angle and the acute angle. And of course, if the transversal goes through at a right angle, then of course they're all 90 degree angles. There is no obtuse and acute angle. All right, so we're going to try to take all that in and do a problem. If line one and line two are parallel, find the measure of angle A and B. Right, see if you could figure this out on your own first by putting the video on pause. Okay, let's go for it here. Trying to find A and B. Well, I know that A plus B add up to 180, but I have two variables there, so that doesn't quite help me yet. I know that this angle up here, the 72 degree angle, and B, those are alternate exterior angles. Those are the small angles, that's the acute angle. So, aha, right away I know what B is. It's the same as that one up here, 72 degrees. So I know this is 72 degrees, and that's half my answer. Remember, I'm trying to find out what A is, trying to find out what B is. I got 72 degrees right off the bat. Now I need to find A. That is the larger of the two angles, the obtuse one. And I know that these two angles together, A and B, add up to 180. So I know that A plus B is 180, right? And but I know what B is, it's 72. So really, I've got A plus 72 is 180. And so we just subtract 72 from both sides. And I've got A. So now this is 108 degrees. And that's what I needed to know. Do those add up to 180? They certainly do. And so there's our answer to that problem. Okay, one more problem. If line one and line two are parallel, find x. So again, we've got this transversal going through, and we're trying to find 2x and 7x. So see if you could figure this out on your own first. Okay, here's one way to think about it. You've got the small angle and the large angle, right? Remember, there's always an acute angle and an obtuse angle, and they're always supplementary angles. The smaller one plus the larger one adds up to 180 degrees. So 2x plus 7x has to be 180 degrees. Now, maybe you didn't think about it that way. Here's what somebody else might have done. You said, well, if this is 7x, this angle down here is also 7x because those are the corresponding ones. And then it's easy to see why these two really are supplementary angles, 7x plus 2x, add up to 180. So I get the same equation, thinking about it a little differently. Now, if I divide by 9, what would x be? Be 20 degrees. So that's the first question, find x. Second part, find the measure of angle A. Okay, what's A? Oh, A is the same thing as 7x, right? A, because those are vertical angles, A is the same thing as 7x, and 7x is 7 times 20, or 140 degrees. And so those were the two things we were asked to do, and that would be our answer. Let's just look at this one more time. Remember, if R is parallel to S, we came up that A, D, E, and H were all the same measure, and B, C, E, F, and G were all the same measure. But the other thing is, all these pairs of angles add up to 180. So, like E and G add up to 180, G and H add up to 180, H and F, etc. So, basically, if you take the smaller angle, that's what I just did in this last problem, the smaller angle plus the larger angle. Add up to 180. So I'm just going to put I really mean the measure of the smaller angle and the measure of the larger angle add up to 180. So I could write here D and F, for instance, add up to 180. You could take any of the obtuse angle, add it to any of the acute angle, and it would add up to 180. So if I took B, for instance, I can add it to one of the larger angles like H, and that should also be 180. Okay? So these are the larger angles, A, D, E, and H. These are the smaller angles. And any one of these added to any one of these is 180. They're supplementary angles. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.